Welcome to a third video on integration involving trig substitution. Let's go ahead and start off with a quick review again. In the first video, we reviewed how to integrate involving the square root of a squared minus x squared, where we let x equal a sine theta. Then in part two, we showed how to integrate when we had something in the form of the square root of a squared plus x squared, when we let x equal a tangent theta. And in this video, we'll take a look at integrals involving the square root of x squared minus a squared, or we'll let x equal a secant theta. And when we let x equal a secant theta, the square root of x squared minus a squared will equal plus or minus a tangent theta. And that's based upon the identity secant squared theta minus 1 is equal to tangent squared theta. So let's go ahead and look at an example. One of the things we have to get good at is recognizing the form. So here we have the square root of x squared minus 25, so it does fit the form of x squared minus a squared. But again, before we jump into trig substitution, we should check to make sure we can't use just basic u substitution. If we let u equal x squared minus 25, du would be 2x dx, so that wouldn't fit. If we let u equal the denominator, that wouldn't work either. So we'll go ahead and proceed with using trig substitution, and we have an integral in the form of x squared minus a squared, so we'll let x equal a secant theta. So a squared is equal to 25, therefore a equals 5, so x equals 5 secant theta, therefore differential x is equal to 5 secant theta tangent theta d theta. Let's go ahead and model angle theta in a right triangle. So if this is angle theta, secant theta is equal to x over 5. So the hypotenuse would be x, and the adjacent side would be 5. Therefore, this other leg would be the square root of x squared minus 5 squared, or x squared minus 25. Okay, let's go ahead and perform the substitution now. In the numerator, we're going to have the square root of x squared minus 25, or 25 secant squared minus 25. That'll give us 5 tangent theta. X is equal to 5 secant theta. And dx is equal to 5 secant theta tangent theta d theta. Let's go ahead and simplify this. We have a 5 over 5. We also have a factor of secant theta. So we're left with 5 times the integral of tangent squared theta d theta. Now from a previous video, if we have factors of tangents and no secants, we want to replace tangent squared theta with secant squared theta minus 1. So let's go ahead and do that. Now from here, I think we can use basic integration formulas. We'd have 5 times the antiderivative of secant squared theta would be tangent theta. And the antiderivative of 1 with respect to theta would be theta. Now this is our antiderivative in terms of theta, but we have to express it in terms of x. So let's go back to our right triangle and express theta in terms of x. Tangent theta would be the opposite side over the adjacent side, or the square root of x squared minus 25 all over 5 minus angle theta. Let's go ahead and use this equation here and solve it for theta. So the first step, we'll divide both sides by 5. So we have x over 5 equals secant theta. Then we'll take inverse secant of both sides. So we have inverse secant of x over 5 equals theta. So let's go ahead and replace theta with inverse secant, x over 5 plus c. And let's go ahead and distribute the 5. Notice it'll simplify out in this first product. So we'll have the square root of x squared minus 25 minus 5 inverse secant x over 5 plus c. That's going to do it for this video. We've now covered the three types of integrals that require trig substitution. In part 4, we'll take a look at a couple more challenging integrals, one that requires completing the square in order to make the integral fit the specific form for trig substitution. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.